Welcome back to NCERT Class 11 Fine Arts Series. We are going to see post-Mauryan trends in Indian art and architecture, part 2. Please do check out the part 1 video before seeing this if you have not seen the part 1. And this is an initiative of Vaish IAS and it's a free initiative, and please do support us. If not, support is not good, then we will be changing it into paid course. Please do support us. Now let's see the Buddhist monuments in South India. We have seen about the Barhud Stupa and Sanchi Stupa in the previous video. Now let's see in the South India. In Andhra Pradesh, the stupa sites is there in Jagayapeta, Amaravati, Bhattiprolu, Nagarjunagunda, Koli. These are some of the important places where you can find the stupas in South India. We are going to see about the Amaravati stupa in detail. The Amaravati stupa has a Mahachaitya. Mahachaitya is the biggest Chaitya hall. Chaitya hall is a prayer hall which is important for the prayers and gatherings, and had many sculptures which are now preserved in Chennai Museum. This Amaravati stupa is not like in full good condition, so they have preserved the excavation. We have got few things, and we have preserved that in Chennai Museum, Amaravati Site Museum, and National Museum, New Delhi, and British Museum, London. Okay, and Amaravati stupa also has the Pradikshina Pada. Pradikshina Pada is the place where we circling the stupa, where we are supposed to walk, and it is enclosed within a Vedika. Vedika is like a compound wall on which Torana is also is also decorated, and these walls have narrative sculptures depicted on them. And the Domical stupa structure is covered with relief stupa and sculptural slabs, which is also a unique feature of this stupa. The Torana of Amaravati has disappeared. The Torana is not found in the Amaravati stupa, and it has disappeared over a period of time. Events from the life of Buddha, Jataka stories are depicted. The interior space in the composition is created by different postures of figures, such as semi-back, back, profile, frontal, semi-frontal. Like this, figures have been given different postures. Not only the front of the figures has been sculptured, the semi-back, back, everything has been sculptured here. The sculpture form in this area is characterized by intense emotions. Intense emotions is being given to every sculptures here. The bodies are shown with three bends in the Tribhanga posture. In the Tribhanga posture, and the cultural composition is more than complex than at Sanchi. The linearity becomes flexible, and dynamic movements, like they have been given different forms, like frontal posture, as we saw in the previous slide. They are given different postures, like front, back, front, everything is shown. That is, the dynamic movement is shown. So this breaks the staticness form. The idea of creating three-dimensional space in the relief sculpture is devised by using pronounced volume, angular bodies, and complex overlapping. This is how the 3D images are created, by pronounced volume, angular bodies, and complex overlapping. Absolute attention has been paid to the clarity of the form, despite its size and role in the narrative. The clarity of the form is, this has to be identified as this. So this is an example of a sculpture found in Amaravati stupa, this image. There are number of Jataka schemes that has not been yet completely identified. We know few Jataka stories. We also saw about Rurur Jataka, we know Kyun Maya Devi dream, and some Jataka stories we know, but few of the scene that is found in the this stupa has not been identified completely. And the depiction of the birth event. This is what is the Kyun Maya Devi dream. The Kyun is reclining on a bed, surrounded by female attendant, and a small sized elephant is carved on the upper frame of the composition, showing the Kyun of the Maya dream of the Maya Devi. In another relief, four events related to the birth of Buddha is also shown. Now let's see about the stupa in Nagarjanakonda and Koli. The animated movement gets reduced in the sculptures of this Nagarjanakonda and Koli around 3rd century common era. Even within the relatively low relief volume than an Amaravati sculptures, artists at Nagarjanakonda and Koli managed to create the effect of protruding surfaces of the body, which is suggestive in nature and look very integral. Though it is not very good as Amaravati stupa, they managed to bring a good sculptures, which is suggestive in nature. The independent Buddha images are also found in Amaravati, Nagarjanakonda and Guntepalli in Andhra Pradesh. The Guntepalli is a rock cut cave site which is located near Elluru. The small apsidal and circular Chaitya halls have been excavated belonging to the 2nd century BCE. This most of the rock cut caves, if you see, it will be belonging to before common era. And after common era, we can see the construction of the stupas and many other things. You have to follow these timelines. The other important site where rock cut stupa has been excavated is Anakapalli near Visakhapatnam. So where we see rock cut caves in South India for this Buddhist monument is Guntepalli and Anakapalli, both located in Andhra Pradesh. In Karnataka, Sannadi in Gulbarga district has the largest stupa site which has been excavated so far. It has also a stupa like one decorated in this stupa is almost like an Amaravati stupa decorated with sculptural relief. Large numbers of stupas were constructed, but also eventually temples, chaityas and viharas were also constructed. But we do not get a full structured chaitya or viharas that are survived till date. But we do get evidences that has been constructed. Among the important structured viharas, we should be mentioned by Sanchi apsidal chaitya structure. That is temple number 18, which is a simple shrine having front pillars and a hall at a back. This is one important viharas to be mentioned. And other one is at Guntepalli, where we see the rocket caves. It also has temples. This temple has Buddha images and also images of bodhisattvas like Avalokiteshvara, Padmabani, Vajrabani, Amitabha and Maitreya are also sculpted here. And with the rise of Vajrayana Buddhism, many bodhisattva images were added to the part of this temples. And these qualities has been propagated by Buddhist religions principles for the welfare of the masses. Now let's see about the caves of the Western India. Three architectural types were executed in the Western side. The apsidal vault roof Chaitya halls, which is found in Ajanta, Pitalkora and Baja. Apsidal vault roof pillarless hall, which is found in Thane, Nadsur and in Maharashtra. Flat roof quadrangular hall with a circular chamber at the back, found in Kondiviti in Maharashtra. So these are the three types of architecture that has been found in the Western caves. The front of the Stythia Hall is dominated by motif or a semicircular Chaitya arch and with an open front which has a wooden facade, and in some cases there is no dominating Chaitya arch. Chaitya arch is present in some and it is not dominating in some, like found in Kondivitte. In all the Chaitya caves, a stupa is found at the back, which is a common feature of the Chaitya caves. Because Chaitya is a prayer hall, so we find a stupa at the back. Modifications were made to the standard plan of the upsided vault roof variety, where the hall becomes rectangular like Ajanta cave number 9, which is a stone screen wall as a facade. It is also found at Bedsa, Nasik, Karla and Kanheri. Now, Chaitya Hall. Chaitya Hall is nothing but the prayer hall which is used during that time. Karla, the place called Karla, there only the biggest Chaitya Hall has been excavated. This is the Chaitya Hall that has been excavated from Karla. And the cave consists of an open courtyard with two pillars and a stone screen wall to protect it from rain. A veranda, stone screen wall as facade, an upside wall to Chaitya Hall with pillars and a stupa was there at the back. The Karla Chaitya Hall is decorated with human and animal figures. The Chaitya Hall has the walls around it, so the walls of that was decorated with human and animal figures. They are heavy in their execution and move in the picture space. The elaboration over the Karla Chaitya Hall is observed in the Kanheri cave number 3. This cave was not fully finished. The interior work of the cave was, this is the Kanheri unfinished Chaitya cave, and it shows how the carving had been progressed, carving skills were being progressed from time to time. A quadrangular flat roofed variety became most preferred design and is mostly found in many places. Viharas. Viharas are the dwelling places, and the viharas are excavated in all the cave sites. The plan of vihara consists of a veranda, a hall and cells around the walls of the hall. So important vihara caves are cave number 12 of Ajanta, Bedsa cave number 11, Nashik cave number 3, 10 and 17. The early vihara caves were carved from the interior decorative motifs like Chaitya arcs and Vedika designs over the cell doors of the cave. The facade design in the Nasik cave number 3, 10 and 17 became a distinct achievement. The most distinguished feature was that it was nice. The vihara caves at Nasik were excavated with front pillars carved with Ghata base and Ghata capital, and it was also found with human figures. One such vihara was excavated in Junar in Maharashtra. It is called Ganesh Leni popularly because an image of Ganesha belonging to a later period was also installed in it, so it was called as Ganesh Leni. And a stupa was added at the back of the hall of vihara, and it became a Chaitya vihara. The stupas in the 4th and 5th centuries common era have Buddha images attached. Junar has the largest cave excavations. It has more than 200 caves around the hills of the town. Whereas Kanheri, which is located in Mumbai, has about 108 excavated caves. Most important sites of viharas are Ajanta, Pitalkhora, Ellora, Nashik, Baja, Junar, Kalhara and Kanheri. The Katra Mount, Mathura. This is a seated Buddha that is found in Katra Mount in Mathura. Mathura was a great center for learning and making sculptures during early historic period. The image of Buddha from the Karchana Mount belongs to 2nd century Common Era. It represents Buddha with two Bodhisattva attendants. Here are the two Bodhisattva attendants. This is the Buddha, center one. He is seated in Padmasana and right hand is in Abhaya Mudra. You can see this clearly. This image is seated Buddha, Abhaya Mudra, and raised little above the shoulder level, whereas the left hand is placed on the left thigh. The Ushanisha, that is hair knot, is shown with the vertically raised position. Here is the hair knot. Mathura sculptures from this period are made with light volume, having a fleshy body. The shoulders are broad. Sankati, that is the garment, covers one shoulder and has been made visible, covering the left hand, whereas covering the torso. Okay. The Buddha is seated on a lion throne. The attendants figures are identified as the images of Padmabani and Vajrabani Bodhisattvas. The two Bodhisattvas were there on the left and right. There are Vajrabani and Padmabani, and one holds a lotus and other holds a Vajra. So Padma is what? Lotus, and Vajram is thunderbolt. So they are called as that way. They wear crowns and are on either side of the Buddha. The halo round the head of the Buddha is very large and it is decorated with the simple geometric motifs. They bear lot of movement in the picture space. Flexibility replaces the earlier rigidity in the images and giving them a more earthy look. Curves of the body are delicately carved. This and all has to be noted that this is not linear. This curves is very delicately carved, and the upright posture of the Buddha creates a movement of in the space. So the face round the with fleshy cheeks. The bulge of the belly is sculpted with controlled musculature, and numerous examples of sculptures from Kushana period at Mathura is available, but this image representative as important for the understanding of the development of the Buddha image in those periods. Please do subscribe to the channel and watch our other playlist also. And WhatsApp to the mentioned number for the details of the India's biggest test series. Thank you.